With Android Q, apps can offer a full edge-to-edge screen experience, regardless of whether gestures or buttons are enabled for navigation. All apps targeting Q in the Play Store should move to implementing an edge-to-edge experience by drawing app content from the top screen edge to the bottom screen edge. The recommended way to achieve this is to render the app content under a transparent navbar. In order to make your app render content under the navbar, start by making the navigation bar transparent. You can also make the status bar transparent to get the full height of the screen. You can do this by setting your theme as shown here. For API 29, it's heavily encouraged to implement this, and note that apps can optionally do this before API 29. Alternatively, you can make the navigation bar transparent programmatically by setting navigation bar color and status bar color on a window object. Starting with Android Q, the system is responsible for providing background protection of navbar elements such as buttons and bars against app contents. On higher-end devices, this means if an app requests a transparent navbar, the system will adjust the navbar's UI color based on the app content drawn behind it. For example, if you have a dark background, the system will provide a light UI. On devices with lower performance, the system is still responsible for drawing a translucent navbar. It draws a light or dark screen behind the system UI, depending on whether the app requested light or dark system buttons in the navbar. You also need to set the system UI visibility flex to extend underneath the system bars so your app can render content under the navbar. The system UI visibility APIs on Vivo objects allows a number of flex to be set. The most common flex you will use for edge-to-edge experience are shown here. When these flex are specified together, you are telling the system that you want your app to be displayed full screen, as if the navigation and status bars are not there. Set these flags on create or at any point after that in the lifecycle. This lays out your view from edge to edge. By the way, if your app uses coordinator layout, drawer layout, or a similar layout and sets fit system windows true, then the layout underscore stable and layout underscore full screen flags are set automatically. However, those views do not set the layout underscore height underscore navigation flag. Well, just to be safe, you can set all three flags all the time. Also, if you're already setting a combination of flags on your layout, make sure you don't wipe out your existing flags. For more details, watch the Becoming a Master Window Fitter talk by Chris Baines, which I linked in the notes below. And that's it! To ensure the best user experience, make sure your app offers an edge-to-edge screen experience and watch the gestural navigation thereby to learn more about gestural navigation and how to avoid conflicts with the system home and back gestures. Thank you for watching! Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more awesome Android videos. See you next time!